Hi, welcome to Grade 9 Physics. Today we are going to take the part 5 of lesson motion. In the last lesson we discussed about acceleration. Okay, so I just want to recall what are the things we covered in the last class. So we were talking about acceleration. Acceleration is denoted by the letter A. Acceleration is the rate of change of velocity. The equation for acceleration is v minus u divided by t, where v is final velocity, u is initial velocity, and t is the time taken. A is a which quantity? It is a vector quantity. What is a vector quantity? Vector quantity is a physical quantity which has both magnitude and direction. So acceleration is a vector quantity. What is its unit? Its unit is meter per second square. Okay, so these are the things we covered in the last class. If you have not watched the previous videos, please visit my Facebook page Behrin Tutor and watch the videos. And if you have any doubt regarding any of the portions I have explained, please leave a comment. Okay, I am happy to help you. Okay, so today what I am planning is that we can discuss some questions related to acceleration, and we can solve some numericals where we have to use the equation acceleration is equal to v minus u divided by t. Okay, you can see some observations here. So there are two tables are given over here. So it is a observation of velocity and different time intervals. Okay, you can see that time equal to zero. Normally when we are telling about time equal to zero, students ask when time becomes zero. Actually, when time becomes zero means zero time means when we start our observation. That is the meaning of the statement when time equal to zero. That means that particular time when you started your observation. So you can see that on the first table, this is my table one. In table one, you can see that the time is zero. That means when I started my observation, the velocity or the object is at rest. That is why its velocity is zero. Then after 1 second, its velocity increased to 4. After 2 seconds, its velocity increased to 8. After 3 seconds, its velocity increased to 12. So you can see that in each time interval of 1 second, for the time interval of 1 second, there is an increase in the velocity. 4 meters per second. That means from 4 it became 8, from 8 it became 12, like that. For each time interval of 1 second, there is an increase in velocity. How much increase? 4 meters per second. In all the time interval, it maintains the same increase in speed. Okay, so these type here you can see that this one is constant acceleration. Constant acceleration or uniform acceleration means everywhere there is a change in speed. That's why the object is accelerating. But how the change happens? It is in a regular manner. Every time the speed increases by 4 meters per second. Okay, so these kind of motions are called uniform motion. But we know that these kind of motions are not that regular, okay, because when you are traveling in a car or something like that, the speed changes very rapidly. Okay, so let's come to the next example. When I started my observation, the object was at rest. That is why its initial velocity is zero. After 1 second, it became 1. After 2 seconds, it became 4. And after 3, it is 5. You cannot find any regularity. There is a increase in speed, but there is no regular. There is no uniform manner for this one. Okay, so these type of motion are called non-constant acceleration. That means the acceleration is not constant, or non-uniform acceleration. Non-uniform acceleration means there is acceleration. That means the speed of the object is changing, but there is no uniformity in that increase. Where in a uniform acceleration, the acceleration remains a constant. That means the object is accelerating, but whenever you are checking that increase in speed, you can see that increase is happening in a uniform manner. Okay, so that question can be asked, differentiate between uniform acceleration and non-uniform acceleration. I think using this table, it is very clear for you what is the difference between uniform acceleration and non-uniform acceleration. Okay, so this one concept was left from the portion acceleration. Now let's have a look at the textbook questions. I have to solve some of the textbook questions. So textbook, I think it is page number 104, page number, yeah, it is 103. You can see some questions. Okay, so before I am going to do example 8.4. Starting from a stationary position, that means whenever you are doing a physics problem, the thing is that don't look for the data given there in the beginning. Okay, read the question and try to imagine the situation first, then take out the data. Okay, starting from a stationary position, that means when you start observing the object was at rest. That means its initial velocity u is equal to zero. Then Rahul paddles his bicycle. Then he started to paddle his bicycle, attain a velocity of 6 meters per second in 30 seconds. Okay, that means initially u was zero. Then what happened? Then he started pedaling the cycle. The velocity became 6 meters per second, which is the final v. Okay, how much time he took for this change? 30 seconds. Then he applies brake. Okay, so we are dividing this one into two sections. First, he started from rest, he pedaled, he attained a velocity in 30 seconds. So this is the first part. In the second part, look at the second part, what they are doing. He applies brake such that the velocity of the bicycle comes down to 4 meters per second. So when he was moving the 6 meters per second, he applied brake. Of course, he is applying brake for decreasing the speed, so it became 4 meters per second in next 5 seconds. Okay, calculate the acceleration of the bicycle in both cases. Okay, first, so you have two situations. You have to separate it into two different portions. And okay, in the first case, u is 0, v is 6 meters per second, and time interval is 30. So what equation? V minus u divided by t. V is equal to how much? 6 minus 0 divided by 30. So your answer will be how much? Your answer will be 0.2 meter per second square. This will be your answer. Never forget to write units. Okay, 0.2 meter per second. Now let's have a look at the second situation. He started from 6. So initial u is equal to 6, v is equal to 4. So 4 minus 6 divided by 5. How much it will become? It will become 2 by 5. So the answer is 2 by 5 meter per second. Or if you want, is correct, is minus 2 by 5 because it is 4 minus 6 minus 2 by 5, which is equal to minus 0.4 meter per second square. So in the first case, his speed is increasing, so it is accelerating. Look at this one here, the acceleration is negative, so the object is decelerating. Okay, so this is decelerating, means you can find out like its speed is decreasing. Okay, decreasing speed, decelerating, and this one is accelerating. Okay, so this is question. I think only one question is given there. Let's have a look at the unsolved questions in this one. Which are the questions not solved here? So these are the questions. Okay, page number 103, some questions are given there. This is your question. When will you say a body is in uniform acceleration? I already told, when the object is speed is increasing uniformly. When the speed is increasing uniformly, you can say that it is uniform acceleration. Non-uniform acceleration, speed is increasing non-uniformly. Or you can add when the acceleration is constant. When A is constant, you can say uniform acceleration. This is constant acceleration, uniform acceleration, they all are the same. Now let's look at the next question. A bus decreases its speed from 80 km per hour to 60 km per hour in 5 seconds. Find the acceleration of the bus. Here the problem is that we have two kind of unit, kilometer per hour, kilometer per second. So first you have to do is that you have to convert kilometer per hour into seconds. So first we have to convert 80 km per hour into meter per second, 60 km per hour into. So, which is U here, when you started your observation, what was the speed of the object? So, it is U is 80, B is 60, time is 5 seconds, and acceleration is V minus U divided by T. Now, we have to convert. So, 80 kilometer per hour, how much? 80 into 5 by 80. I need calculator. 80 into 5 by 18, how much do it become? So here 80 kilometer per hour is equal to, we have to convert into meter per second. So for converting kilometer per hour into meter per second, multiply by 5 by 18. So you will get the answer 22.22 meter per second. Okay, now let's change 60 kilometer per hour into meter per second. 60 into 5 divided by 18, so that also will come how much? 300 divided by 18. So the answer will be how much? 16.67 meter per second will be your answer. So I converted kilometer per hour into meter per second in both cases, and the time is given as 5 seconds. So acceleration is equal to final. Don't write it like, because when you started, it is not, you are not supposed to write the big number first. Okay, it is not like that. You have to write what is the velocity, final velocity. So here final velocity is 16.67 minus 22.22 divided by 5. Okay, so 16.67 minus 22.22 will become how much? It is equal to minus 5.5, and that divided by 5, you have to calculate that divided by 5 is equal to 1 minus 1.1 is your answer, 1.1 meter per second. Go and don't forget to write the unit. Okay, so if it is kilometer per hour, convert into meter per second, then do use the equation. Then one more question is there. A train starting from a railway station. So the train is starting. So always look for these kind of hints. Okay. So train is starting means initial velocity U is equal to zero. Then and moving with uniform acceleration attains a speed. So after some time it attains a speed of 40 kilometer per hour. So convert into meter per second, 40 into 5 by 18. So 40 into 5 by 18, and that one in which time? 10 minutes. You cannot write as it is, because look here, one is in hour, one is in minute. You cannot continue like that. You have to make sure that all are, or suppose if time is there, all the time are in same unit. So we are following SI unit here. So 10 minutes is equal to how many seconds? 10 into 60, 600 seconds. So convert 40 into 5. 200 divided by 18 is how much? It will come 11.11. Okay, 11.11. So what is your acceleration? Acceleration A is equal to B minus U. That is 11.11 divided by 600. 11.11 divided by 600 will be very small number. It will be 0.018 meter per second square. This is how we will solve the question. I think both the questions you can see, it is just there is nothing much to think about. You have a direct equation A is equal to B minus U. Only the thing is that you have to convert kilometer per hour into meter per second. Okay, now I just want to discuss an activity is given here that are actually very good questions. Okay, I like that question, so I am going to discuss some of that questions here. In your everyday life, you come across the range of motion in which acceleration is in the direction of motion. Acceleration is in the direction of motion. We can say example of this one as free fall is an example, like where an object is free fall. Okay, it's an example for this one, where free fall means the object is falling down because of gravity. Where the acceleration is acting in the downward direction, the same time motion is also happening in the same. Acceleration is against the direction of motion. When you are braking, when a car is moving and you are applying a brake, in that case, acceleration is acting against the direction of motion. And while applying brake, you can apply brake because it is negative acceleration. Okay, negative acceleration is uniform. Again, free fall is an example for that one, where the acceleration is same. Okay, this it happens in a uniform. Acceleration is uniform. Usually, a car moving with different increase in speed. Can you identify one example of each of the above type of motion? Actually, these are some good questions. It can be asked for exams also. Again, acceleration is in the direction of motion, free fall. That means a object falls down because of gravity. Where the object is falling down, acceleration also will be in the same direction. Acceleration is against the direction when you are applying brake to stop a car. Acceleration is uniform in free fall because every time, because there the gravity is applying the force, so it will be same everywhere. Acceleration is uniform when you are moving in a car. The regular examples, okay, like that. So that is about the portion acceleration. Acceleration is a very important concept. You have to make the concept you have to use whenever you study physics. Okay, so make sure the concept is very clear for you. It is not there at that hard concept. The next one is graphical methods. So in the next class, we will discuss about graphical methods. Okay, so please do some questions. I think end of the chapter also some questions are given there. If you are finding, if you are getting time, try to solve that one. Okay, so bye. That's it for today.